You see that Bible over there? No, no, not that one. The old one. The old one. There you go. That's the one. See this? This is my grandfather. We was gonna bury him with it, but the Bible shouldn't be buried or left up on the shelf. It should be read here. Read this.
Presented to Wendell P. Wright on his 8th birthday from his friend John Eskew.
May 31st, 1884?
1884.
Who was John Eskew?
He was a cotton farmer. 2,000 acres, 100 slaves. He released all the slaves before the war was over. Almost all of them stayed.
They wanted to remain slaves?
No, they just loved him. They loved him for what he did. He got them all jobs, gave them more pay than they would ever get on the outside, and he gave them 10 acres of land to build a house.
You gotta be kidding me. Why would he do that?
He didn't have to do that, I can tell you that, but sit down. Let me tell you something. The day he freed those slaves, he lined them all up in front of him. And he had his hat in his hand. Now remember, he's one of the richest men in the state. He had his hat in his hand, and he asked them all to forgive him for what he had done. He had done something wrong. But not only that, he asked them to forgive all the people who had done something wrong to them, all the slave owners, all the white folks, whether they asked for forgiveness or not.
How'd that go over?
Kind of like your last sermon.
Okay.
Well, Mr. Eskew, he taught your great-great-grandfather, Wendell, how to read. He gave him this Bible, and boy, he decided to be a preacher right then and there. That one act of grace changed history, Sam. And that's the point. This was what your 8-year-old great-grandfather wrote in return.
I promise to pray for you every day, ask your forgiveness, grant you the same, and be your friend always. Wendell P. Wright. That's nice.
Nice. That becomes life's work. God put him on the earth to do this. Probably changed some hearts and some lives. Probably kept it away from some lynchings, some billy clubs. That's what I'm talking about. That's my point. That is grace. Reconciling starts with forgiveness. That's the only thing that makes a difference, eh? You can never underestimate the power of grace, boy. It's powerful.